Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Guys, we're about to start a venture into the fast growing, exciting world of kayak bass fishing. So you guys stay tuned right here to Greenfish Nation to find out what kayak we've chosen, what modifications that we're going to do to it to make it the ultimate one-man fishing machine. Alright guys, we're back. We're here to let you know that we've chosen to pick up a Perception Outlaw 11.5 for our ultimate fishing machine. Stay tuned for our modifications right here on Greenfish Nation. Guys, in kayak bass fishing, one of the most important pieces of equipment that you can have on any kayak is going to be your PFD, your personal flotation device. This one is made by Chinook. It's a very good PFD. Like I said, it's designed specific for kayaking. It's open on the side so you don't have any restrictions in rowing. It has a high float on the back, plus it's mesh on the back here to keep you cool in the warm summertime. It's got multiple pockets in the front for tools and accessories, scent pockets and different things like that, guys. So you always want to start out with a high quality PFD. Could mean the difference in you fishing another day and not. So make sure you always have that PFD on you when you're fishing, guys. All right, guys, the next accessory I've added to this kayak is a Yak Attack Black Pack. This is the 13 by 16. It'll hold 6 boxes upright of the 9 by 14 by 2 inch. It'll also hold one laying down flat. I'll show you on this other side. You can secure this down on the corners. It has, this kayak has a bungee system in it that works great. This black pack comes with these straps here that have the little securing straps on there. This thing works great. It's got snap lid hinges on it. It all has rubber grommets around the four corners, so it's quiet, so you can try to remain stealthy when you're getting tackle or whatever you want to store in here. This particular model came with 6 rod holders. I added 2 extra rod holders to it. All right, guys, another thing that I've done with this kayak is I've went in and I've done some internal wiring on it. I do fish at nights quite a bit. Plan on fishing some tournaments, so navigation lights are a must. And I'll show you how these guys light up in a little while. This is the rear light. It's got to be a 360 degree white light. This one sticks up above my seat and everything, so I should be able to be visible for 360 degrees. And I'll show you the front. All right, guys, these little white strip lights right here. I have one on each side. I have a red one and a green one. And that'll indicate our direction of travel to oncoming boats and kayaks while we're out on the lake. And those are all LED self-sticking. And then the wire, like I said, is all wired internally. Tried to keep everything wired internally, that way I'm not tangling up on anything. Also, I'm storing my PFD when I'm not on the water. I keep it up here underneath this little Perception kayak. They call it a fish basket, so I keep it right under there. All right, guys, you know we all get into situations where we need a dip net for fish. I wanted something that would help me keep this dip net I've got here handy. So I got this Railblazer dip net holder. It's a roller holder. You can keep dip nets, paddles, or whatever in it. I can just snap that baby in right there. It's right there out of the way, and I don't have to worry about it running off on me. I'll probably eventually put a leash on it just in case, so I don't drop my dip net, or I'll probably put a piece of pool float or something on it here. That way I can keep up with my dip net. But this thing here, I'm really gonna enjoy, I promise you. All right, guys, I don't know where all of you guys fish at, but I fish mainly down here in Texas, Oklahoma, Louisiana right now, and it gets hot down here in the summer. So it's real important to be able to stay hydrated. Picked up this little cooler off of Amazon, and it goes right here on the back of your seat. It hooks up with these bungees. It'll hold 4 large Gatorades and a 10-pound bag of ice. You got a little accessory pack back here. I just keep beef jerky, crackers, and stuff like that back here that's not real heat sensitive to that, but that's a must-have, especially fishing in the summertime here in Texas. All right, guys, another accessory that I have that I like is I bought these little dry boxes from Walmart. They're like $4 a piece. They have a little seal on them. I keep my anchor system, which is a retractable dog leash. And then this is a 1.5-pound folding kayak anchor. I keep those right there handy for me. And it comes with these little bungee cords. You can just bungee it right in place. That way when you're traveling, you can keep up with it. I have another one for the other side. This one's a little different color, just because that's what I could get. These are made by Ozark Trail. I believe they're 388. And I put my cell phone, my wallet, anything that I don't want to get wet in here. And this one just goes right on the other side, just like this one. You just bring it over here, and it's got the little balls. And you just snap that thing in place, and you're good to go. You can travel down the road or whatever. You can leave those on there. These T-lock rope locks, they're additional also, as well as some of the Railblazer tracks. There's 2 6-inch tracks and 1 3-inch track. And then you got the tracks that come with it, so you can add rod holders, different accessories, or whatever. I don't know about you guys, but I think one of the very important things that every fishing boat should have, no matter what size it is a good depth finder, fish finder, electronics, just let's say. I put a 12-inch Lowrance Hook TS. It does 2D imaging, it does 3D imaging, it does side imaging, as well as it has a chip in it for all the lakes here in North America. It also tells time and temperature, and it has alarms and things that you can set so you can get back from your tournaments on time, guys. I think that's going to be the brains of this operation right here, guys. The transducer in this one is mounted up underneath the hull. It has a special spot for this triple shot transducer, so it's protected in the keel, and you can still get good imaging on your 2D down and your sides. So I'm really looking forward to this 12-inch hook going to work for me. All right, guys, 2 small things that I've added to the kayak is I ordered a pair of aluminum pliers. They have stainless steel cutting jaws in them. They come with this little leash right here to keep you from losing them. I just stick them right down there in the scupper hole, and I clip them right there. The other thing is I have a Yak Gear paddle leash. I'll probably get another one of these ordered for the dip net as well. I didn't think about that when I was getting this, but that'll go for my paddle. That helps me keep up with my pliers where they're handy. I can just lay them around wherever. They're out of the way, but I won't worry about them getting dropped in the water. All right, guys, another very important accessory that any kayaker can have is a good paddle. This is a Bending Branches carbon fiber. It's a 280 centimeter paddle. This boat's 11'5", This paddle's gonna be about 9'5". You do set up high out of the water. I have a paddle keeper over here, as well as it has a safety clip on it. And then I can always put my paddle leash on there, because this paddle by itself is about $225 to $250, depending on where you buy it. But if you take care of it, I think it'll last you a lifetime. All right, guys, you know you can't have a YouTube channel unless you have filming equipment. I bought the YoloTech 20. I wired it in to a marine connection, just like you would have on your regular bass boat. I hardwired it in here to the front. I'm using a GoPro 3 Plus on the front here. All right, guys, here on the back, we have a 53-inch adjustable YoloTech. I'm really enjoying it. It's got a shotgun mic on the back as well. I think this is really gonna be a good asset for our filming. So we have dual cameras, or one fore and one aft. I also have a bar for this camera set up where I can put two GoPros. That way I can get different angles. So we're excited about all that. All right, guys, we've saved the best for last.
All right, guys, we talked about our lighting system. We have a main switch. Controls all of our electronics. We have a switch for our cameras. We have a switch for our interior lighting. I have two green lights that light up the front of the cockpit here. And last but not least, we have our navigation lights. Red on that side, green on this side. They're extremely bright. So we shouldn't have any trouble being seen out on the water. And then we got the white 360 in the back.
Guys, I hope you've enjoyed this session of Greenfish Nation, learning about our accessories and our new kayak, our new venture into the kayak fishing sport. If you like our content, drop us a subscribe. We'd really appreciate that. Give us a thumbs up. Leave us a comment if you feel like we've left something out on this kayak or something we need to add. And we appreciate it. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. I want to wish all of you tight lines.